to my YouTube channel. So today I'm finally back and I'm super excited because I'm gonna be doing a Dollar Tree haul. And yeah, so get your popcorn because it's been too long and I've so much tea. There's so much drama that's happened. Like, I'm in high school now, so I'm a freshman, so there's just a ton of drama that's happened and I can't wait to just spill my guts on the internet. Anyway, let's get started. So the first thing I got at the Dollar Tree was these pink and yellow balloons. So these past few months that I've been gone, I've been really getting into balloon art and like I've definitely improved. Like, I used to only be able to make a dog, but now I can make like fairy wings and crowns and like I can make hats, like actual like the Uncle Sam hats, like insane sculptures. And yeah, so I got some supplies. So first I got this like neon baby pink like balloon. It's from the Dollar Tree, so like it's kind of cheap quality, but this is what it looks like blown up. Sports team. So I tried out for the JV volleyball team and I made it, which is, oh my gosh, because I really wanted to make it, so that's good. And anyway, so we had a great season. It was awesome, but the highlight of my season wasn't how many games we won. It was a boy. I know, very cliche, but there's this guy, he's the manager of the volleyball team, and don't worry, he's a student. He's not an adult. I repeat, he is not an adult. Every time I say manager of the volleyball team, people immediately think, like, freaking an adult. Like, no, I'm not into adults, please. Anyway, moving on. He's a junior in high school, and he just, like, comes to our practices and sometimes to our home games, and he just, like, helps out, which is nice. So yeah, I developed a little bit of a crush on him, and it's so stupid, but anyway, I'll just call him Matt, and he was super nice. He's really good at volleyball. It was just, he was awesome. He's pretty decent looking, like, he checked everything. So what would I do around him? Literally, I would fall on the floor. Like, I'm not even exaggerating, like, literally every time he like walked past me, like I would just squat and like lay down on the floor. Like, I don't know what's wrong with me. Like I would just laugh and giggle like a lunatic and just fall on the floor. He definitely noticed how weird I was acting. So that's not good. And then one time before a game, I had trouble with my algebra homework. And I was like, hey, can someone help me? And then I had the brilliant idea of asking Matt. I was like, Matt, I was like, yo, no one asked me to homecoming. You know what? I'm gonna ask Matt to homecoming. Even though, one, I barely talked to him. Two, he doesn't really know me that well. Three, like, he's a junior and I'm a freshman. Like, anyway, it was a stupid, super stupid plan, but I still went on with it anyway. And I made a poster and everything. And since we both play volleyball, I said, the poster said, I would really dig it if you went to HOCO with me. And then as a joke, since he helped me with math homework, I was like, fun fact, my favorite subject is math. So basically it said in really big letters, will you, I would really dig it if you went to HOCO with me. And then under that in like small letters, it said, fun fact, did you know Jenna's favorite subject is math? So yeah, I really went for it, and I saw him during lunch, and there's a video recording of this, I was like, hey Matt, will you go to HOCO with me? And basically, he was like, oh, he started smiling, and like, being really shy, it was awesome, but then he was like, sorry, I can't, because I have a concert that day, and yeah, he's like, I'm super sorry, and I was like, oh no, it's cool. I would say it's a success just because, like, he was really nice about it, and, yeah, so, that happened, and it was great, and it was just a little bit awkward between us, but overall, it was the same thing. I mean, he's a junior, like, I'm a freshman, like, I don't know what I was expecting. Okay, I've just been talking about my life, let's go on to the other thing I got at the dollar store. That's right, I got hair dye from Dollar Tree. Anyway, let's look at what's in here. So it's supposed to look like this. I think I look like this. I'm sorry, like. Anyway, let's see what's inside. I hope I don't get sick. So this is very, not safe looking. It's like this gooey texture and it's blue. So you just like put your hair in it basically and you just let it sit. It's very strange, but it smells super good, guys. Like, what the heck? This smells so good. And then there's one more thing in there. Guys, our coat. I'm in high school, but I still literally act like a 6-year-old. And then the final thing I got from the Dollar Tree are these tattoos. They're super nice looking. Some of the tattoos, I've used some of them, but this is what some of the tattoos look like.